Shmoop. Have you ever wanted to travel to another dimension?
It's nice this time of year.
What about traveling to? Dramatic pause.
The suspense is killing me.
A third dimension. Dun dun dun. Well, it might sound like we're jetting through the space-time continuum with rocket shoes, but it really just means our world includes length, width, and depth. You know how it's a big deal when some hit movie is shown in 3D? It's because the 3D experience makes the movie feel more like real life. However, considering that our entire lives are in 3D, wouldn't it actually be more interesting to experience 2D? Area is a mathematical term used to express the extent of a two-dimensional space, also known as a plane. In other words, area measures length and width, but not depth, so it occurs entirely in the second dimension. Area is measured in square units, which could be square meters, square miles, or any other sort of square measurement that strikes your fancy.
Even square dancing?
For example, the area of Chicago is 237 square miles, and Calcutta, India, is a whopping 729 square miles. The calculation for area is very simple.
Thank heavens!
You just multiply the length by the width. In this case, we multiply 7 times 5. The type of unit we're using is actually irrelevant to the calculation.
Please use furlongs. Pretty please!
But since you desperately want us to commit, we'll use furlongs. 7 furlongs times 5 furlongs equals an area of 35 furlongs. And there we have our area. That's all there is to it. We hope you've enjoyed your trip to the second dimension. It's a nice place to visit, but you probably wouldn't want to live there.